Hello students, welcome back for another session of class 8, chapter 8, exploring geometrical figures. In that exercise 1, in the previous class we have already discussed some of the questions. Up to 5th question is completed, 6 questions are completed. Now we move on to the question number 7. What is given, let us see. 7 pillars are used to hold a slant iron girder as shown in the figure. Here figure is shown, you can see at page number 193, figure is shown like this. This is the slant, okay. This slant is held by these all 7 pillars, okay. If the distance between every 2 pillars is 1 meter and height of the last pillar is 10.5 meters, the distance between each and every pillar is 1 meter, like that 7 such pillars are used. The last pillar height is given 10.5 meters. Okay. So, find the height of pillars. Find the height of each pillar. You have to find. So, let us see the figure. What is given? How many pillars are used? 7 pillars are used. Question number 7. This is the last pillar. Height of this pillar is 10.5 meters. 10.5 meters. So, a slant is placed like this. By taking the support of 7 pillars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 pillars are used to place this slant in this way. Okay, the distance between one pillar to another pillar is how much? 1 meter. How much? 1 meter. Okay, the distance between one pillar to another pillar is 1 meter. Distance is there. So we have to find the total pillars height individually, we have to find. Okay, first the last pillar, 7th pillar height is how much? 10.5 meters. So let us find the height of the first pillar. Height of the first pillar, I'll write here. Okay, height of first pillar. Let us take that as H1 is equal to first pillar, now take number 1 by the height of the last pillar is how much? How much? It is 10.5. Multiply 10.5. And total number of pillars how many? 7. You get 7 here. Okay? 7 ones are. Point. Here the 3 will go this side. So here 35. 7 5 is 35. That means 1.5 meter. This is the height of the first pillar. In similar way, height of the second pillar. Height of second pillar, take it as H2, okay, that is 2 by 7 into 10.5, 7 ones are same, this will be always 1.5, 2 into 1.5 how much? 3 meters, 2 into 1.5 is 3, so same height of the third pillar, height of third pillar. H3. So third pillar 3 by 7 into, so 10.5. So 7 ones are 7, 1.5 is up. 3 into 1.5, how much? 4.5 meters. So similar way, all 7 pillars height we have to find. Height of 4th pillar H4 is equal to 4 by 7 into 10.5. So 7 ones are 10, 1.5 is a 10.5. So 4 into 1.5 is 6 meters. Next, height of the 5th pillar. Height of 5th pillar. H5. How much will be? 5 by 7 into 10.5. So 7 ones are 7.5 meters. Next, height of the sixth pillar. That is H6. 6 by 7 into 10.5. So 7 1 is 7, 1.5 is 7. So 6 into 1.5 is how much? 9 meters. So the last height of the seventh pillar already given. It is 10.5. Height of seventh pillar already it is given in the question itself. That is H7. How much it is given? 10.5 meter. So heights of each and every pillar it is there. Why we are taking here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that? Because the distance between every pillar is 1 meter only. So everywhere 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 1, 6 like that. Okay. So all 7 pillars individual heights are in this way. You can easily solve. With this question number 7 has been finished. Now we will go for the question number 8. See question number 8. Next one. Let us see what is given. Standing at 5 meters apart from a vertical pole of height 3 meters. That means the pole's height is 3 meters. We are standing 5 meters away from that pole. Okay. The distance between the person who is observing. Who is that? And one girl, Sudha. The girl's name is what? Sudha. She is standing 5 meters away from a vertical pole of height 3 meters. The pole's height is 3 meters. She is standing 5 meters away from it. Okay. Sudha observed a building behind the pillar and found that tip of the pillar is in line with the top of the building. Tip of the pillar is in line with the top of the building. When she is observing, the pillar is in between the girl and the building. Okay, the pillar is in between the girl and the building. So the pillar's height is how much? 3 meters. So what is the height of the building? If the distance between the pillar and building is 10 meters, distance between the pillar and building is 10 meters. Estimate the height of the building. Here we have to estimate the height of the building. Let us draw the picture to understand this question. Okay. So according to the question, we have to draw the figure first. What is given? Standing 5 meters apart from a vertical pole of height 3 meters. So suppose this is the pole. Okay. Pole. Okay. What is the height of this pole? 3 meters. 3 meters is the height of the pole. The girl is standing 5 meters apart from a vertical pole. This is the pole. She is standing 5 meters apart. That means here she is standing. The girl is standing here, suppose. Okay. She is the girl standing here. So how much distance is 5 meters from the girl to the pole? 5 meters distance. The height of the pole is how much? 3 meters. And she is observed, Sudha is observed. This girl name is what? Sudha. Okay, let us write the name of the girl, Sudha. Okay, she is looking at the building. The distance between the building, or if the distance between the pillar and building is 10 meters. From here, the building is 10 meters away. So from here to here, it is 10 meters. How much it is? 10 meters. Understand? So now, this is the building. This is the building, this is the pillar, the pole. Okay? So she is observing the top of the building. So when she is observing this, this top of the pillar and the top of the building both are coming in the same line like this. Okay, understand? This is the figure. When she is observing from here, her eye, see the top of the pole and the top of the building are coming in the same line. Understand? Now we have to find the height of the building. This height of the building, let us assume this as h. This we need to find, height of the building, how much we need to find. Now name this all. Let us take the girl is observing from here, no? Okay? So take this point as O. Take this point as O.
let the pole height as AB. Let the pole height as A. Okay, B. Pole height as AB. The building you take as CD. The building height you have to take as CD. Understand? Okay. So building height is CD. Pole height is AB. Now the girl is observing from the point O. Now let us describe the figure. See, the what is given information from the girl to the pole. How much? 5 meter distance. Then the pole to the building distance is 15 meters. Okay. Now the total distance from the girl to the building is how much? Total 5 plus 10. That is 15 meters. Total from the foot of the building to the point of observation. The girl is observing from here. The building is here. So total is this 5 meters, this 10 meters. Total 15 meters. Okay. O to C. So now you can see this one triangle is ODC. OCD one triangle and OAB another triangle. Understand? OAB is one triangle. OCD is another triangle. Two triangles are similar or not? See here. This is the triangle. First one. Here the girl is standing. O. This is the pole. AB. This is one triangle. The another triangle is bigger one, like this. The girl is standing here now. Okay. Now this is the building height. CD is the building height. In between the pole is there. Understand? AB is here. So now, if you ignore this, these two triangles are similar or not? Two triangles are similar. When the two triangles are similar, the corresponding sides ratio will be equal. The corresponding sides ratio will be equal. That means the corresponding sides will be in proportional. Understand? When the two triangles are similar, the corresponding sides are in proportional. That means the corresponding sides ratio will be equal. Now, what are the triangles we are taking now? OAB is one triangle and OCD is another triangle. OAB and OCD triangles are similar to each other. Understand? With these two figures, this one figure only I have drawn as two figures. OAB is one figure, OCD is another figure. Two triangles. Here from the figure, we can say that triangle OAB, triangle OAD is similar to triangle OCD, triangle OCD. Understand? Now, when the two triangles are similar, their corresponding sides ratio will be equal. So similar triangles, so corresponding sides you see. In triangle OAB, OA. In triangle OAB, OA. OA. The corresponding side in this one what? OC. OA by OC. OA by OC is equal to here AB. This AB is similar to this one what? CD. Corresponding side of this AB is what? CD. Now we are finding the height of the building, that is what? CD. Now substitute the values. OA, that is distance from the girl to the pillar. OA, distance from the girl to the pillar. How much that was? Substitute OA value. OA is how much from the figure? 5 meters. By OC. OC means from here to here, total. OC means OA plus AC. Total 5 plus 10, 15. That is equal to AB. AB what? The height of the pole, that is 3 meters. Next, CD. CD is what? Height of the building. H. That we don't know. That is what we are finding. Now, by doing the cross multiplication. Cross multiply. When you cross multiply, H into 5. That means 5 into H. This is equal to 3 into 15. 3 into 15. Now, 5 into H. 5H is equal to 3 into 15. Is how much? 45. H is equal to now 45. Here the multiplication when it goes that side, it will become denominator. 5 1s are 5 9s are. Then H is equal to what? 9. Now H means what? The height of the building. Therefore, the height of the building is H-E-I-T-H. Height of building. Height of building is how much? 9 meters. Understand? From the given question, first you have to draw the figure like this. The pole's height is 3 meters. So AB you assume as pole height, that is 3 meters. The girl is standing 5 meters apart from the pole. So here one triangle is formed, OAD. The distance from O to A, that is the distance from the girl Sudha to the pole, is 5 meters. It is given in the question. The pole height is 3 meters. Okay, with this one triangle is formed. Next, the pole and the building, they are apart from 10 meters. That means the pole to the building distance is 10 meters. Okay, then the building is behind the pole. The girl is here, the building is here, in between pole is there. When she is looking the top of the building, the top of the pillar also coming in the same line. So when you are joining like this, one more triangle is formed, OCD. OCD. OC means from the distance from the girl to the building. Distance from the girl to the building. So distance from the girl to the pole is 5 meters. Distance from the pole to the building is 10 meters. Total is 15 meters. Okay. The height of the building, we don't know. We are finding that. Okay. Now these are similar triangles. This is one triangle. The full one is another triangle. So two triangles are similar, then the corresponding sides ratio will be equal. So from the figure, triangle OAB is similar to triangle OCD. So the corresponding sides OA, corresponding side of this full triangle is what? OC. So corresponding sides ratio, you substitute the values, but in the cross multiplication, you got the height of the building, that is how much? 9 meters. Understand all of you? Very, very easy. Just read the question, according to the question, draw the picture, then show the two triangles are similar and substitute in that ratio. By doing the cross multiplication, you got the answer. Height of the pole is height of the building is how much? 9 meters. Understand all of you? I hope you followed this. Next, we will move on to the last question of this exercise, that is 9th one. See, question number 9th now. Draw a quadrilateral of any measurements. Construct a dilation of scale factor 3. Scale factor how much? 3. Measure their corresponding sides and verify whether they are similar. Here, quadrilateral. Quadrilateral means either it may be square, rectangle, trapezium, rhombus, kite, anything. These are all the quadrilaterals. Okay. Draw any quadrilateral on the graph sheet. Draw its dilation. Dilation means, I already told you in the previous class, either enlarged size picture or reduced size picture. Okay. The original picture is one. If you increase its size, you draw one figure for that, then that are called dilation. Or you reduce. Suppose you are human being, if you take a picture, that means photograph, that is the dilation of your body. Understand? Enlarged size or reduced size. Dilation means the original picture to the enlarged size picture or reduced size picture. That is what dilation. Now let us draw one original figure and its dilation on the graph sheet. So let us see. So let us take the graph sheet like this. In your graph book, the graph sheet will be there. Okay, all numbers and all lines will be drawn for you in the graph sheet. Just you have to draw y-axis and x-axis. Here I am drawing like this. The vertical line is known as y-axis. The horizontal line is known as x-axis. Okay, the intersection point of the two axis is known as origin. Mark with O. Origin. Okay. Here all lines will be there equally. Okay, for you. So that your name, number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on. Like this, equal distance will be there in your graph sheet. No need of measuring, no need of drawing the lines. You already have the lines in your graph sheet. Okay, horizontally you give the numbers, vertical also you give the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Suppose, like this numbers are given. After that, you draw any quadrilateral. Okay, any type of quadrilateral you draw. I am drawing a square. Suppose I am drawing a square like this. Taking 1 unit, 1 centimeter of each side is of 1 centimeter. See here, from 1 to 2. 1, 2, 2. That means here, 1 centimeter. Here, 1, 2, here also, here, 1 centimeter. Here, 1 centimeter. Here, 1 centimeter. So, I am naming this square, one of the quadrilateral, I am taking as square. So, name the sides A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D is a square. Okay. Now we have to draw its dilation. Dilation means enlarged size or reduced size. As it is a 1 unit square, so it is a very small one. I am going to draw enlarged size of this quadrilateral. Okay. Now join from the O. Join all the vertices. So I am joining all the vertices. Okay. How much it will be? 1 unit. So like this. This. Okay. So join like dotted lines. Use the scale and join the vertices of the all square. What four vertices will be there? No, A, B, C, D. O A, O B, O C, O D. Join like this. After that, 3 times scale factors are much given. 3 times. That means it is 1 unit. You have to draw 3 units. Okay. I am drawing here. So here it is 2, no, 6, where it is 6, okay, from 6 here it is 3 units, 1 unit is there, no? I am going for here like this, 3 units, I will draw, so like this, 3 to 6 will be 1, 2, 3, like that, 3 to 6, 3 units, here again 3 to 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, 3 units, again here 3 units. So, like this. Now it will be 3 units. Here you see 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3. 3 units. Okay? Like this also. Here 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or in your graph sheets, lines will be there. So, no need to worry. So, equal size will get. Now, this is the original square. Okay? I am drawing its dilation. That means I am increasing its size. So, I am giving the name A dash, B dash, C dash, and D dash. Now join these lines. Okay, so in the similar way you draw in your graph sheet, you will be getting correct lines. Okay, like this. Okay, this small picture becomes big one. It is enlarged now. This is the original figure. This is the its enlarged figure, dilation. How much? It is 1 unit square, it is 3 unit square. That means it is increased by 3 units. How much? 3 times. The scale factor. Scale factor, how much? See, this, each one is 1 unit. ABCD square, 1 unit inside. It is 3 units. That means 3 units by 1 unit, how much? 3. Understand? Scale factor is what? 3. So, how I am writing? I will write this scale factor A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash square by A, B, C, D square. So, this is 3 units each. Okay? 3 units square. This is 1 unit square. So, here units cancel. The scale factor is how much? 3. Scale factor is how much now? 3. Understand? Now, corresponding sides, corresponding side from O to A, O to A, okay, by O to A dash, O to A dash. So, this will be equal to OB or OA or OB, all will be same, OB dash, OC by OC dash, OD by OD dash. So all will be, it will be 1 by 3, it will be 1 by 3, it will be 1 by 3, it will be 1 by 3. The square factor is same. Understand? The ratio is same. If you compare the squares now, AB, A dash B dash by AB is equal to B dash C dash by BC is equal to C dash D dash by CD is equal to D dash A dash by DA. See, A dash, B dash, A dash, B dash, how many units? 3 units. A, B, how much? 1 unit. So, all will be 3 by 1. The scale factor is how much? 3. So, understand? In this way, the enlarged size, the dilation of A, B, C, D square is what? A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. So, these two squares are similar. This part of writing part you should write in the lining portion of your graph book. This picture you draw in the graph sheet. Right hand side lining portion will be there now in the graph book. That side you have to write this. Okay. Now the square ABCD is similar to the square A dash, B dash, dash d dash. That means it is the dilation of this original picture. This is the original one. This is the dilation. What is the scale factor? 3. That means it is 3 times bigger than this one. It is 3 times bigger than this figure. Understand? So the scale factor 3, that means every corresponding side, AB's corresponding side is A dash B dash, BC's corresponding side is B dash C dash, DC's corresponding side is C dash D dash, AD's corresponding side is A dash D dash. That means this is 1 unit, this is 3 units, this is 1 unit, this is 3 units, like that. Each and every corresponding side is following the same equal ratio. So similar figure, that is dilation, the size is different but the shape is same. Understand? Enlarged size picture or reduced size picture is known as dilation. Understand what is mean by dilation? Hope you all followed this question. With this question we have completed exercise 8.1. Let us move on to the exercise 8.2. Before you go for exercise 8.2, there is one more important topic that is named as symmetry. What is mean by symmetry? Let us understand the topic symmetry. Let us go for the topic symmetry now. What is mean by symmetry? You may be seeing the pictures in the mirror. Suppose you are standing in front of the mirror like this. Same identical picture you are seeing. The mirror is behaving like a line. So that is identical. Same how you look like. It is same. It will be there. Reflection of your image in the mirror. That is what symmetric figure. Your figure is appearing in the mirror. Same size, same shape. That is what symmetry figure. See, here in the textbook some figures are given. Let us see here. See that butterfly and letter B. See the butterfly and letter B. See in the middle exactly. From the middle line, if you draw a line here, from here in the middle, so the left side and the right side, the butterfly's two wings are there, no? This wing and this wing are both exactly same, identical. Both look like same. If you cut from the middle by drawing a line here, this and this look like same. So this is a symmetric figure. This is a symmetric figure. The line which divides it into two identical, that line is called what? Symmetric line. In the similar way, the letter B also, you see, the English alphabet letter B here. If you draw a line from here, from the middle, upper part and lower part, if you fold like this, if you fold the letter, it will be looking like only one. Understand? So the identical parts, two identical parts are identical parts are done by drawing the line. So upper part and lower part both are what? Symmetric, exactly identical. So this letter is a symmetrical letter. Okay, in this way symmetric figures we will see in this topic. So English letters, alphabets A to Z, some letters are identical by drawing one line or two lines from them in the middle or from the side, anywhere. Suppose for example, if I write a letter, capital letter A, okay, like this. If I draw a line from the middle like this, straight, okay, like this, if I draw, this side, how it is looking? In the similar way, left side and right side both are looking. Understand? Same. This part, how it is visible? It is the same to the right hand side also. So this is a line symmetry. It is also a symmetric one, symmetric figure. How many lines can be drawn like this? Only one line. This one line only divides this figure as two identical figures. Understand? Like this, symmetry will be of three types: line symmetry, point symmetry and rotational symmetry. How many types of symmetry are there? Point symmetry, line symmetry and rotational symmetry. What does it mean? What is mean by line symmetry? What is mean by point symmetry? What is mean by rotational symmetry? Let us discuss now. Symmetry of three types. First one is point symmetry, second, line symmetry, and the third one is rotational symmetry. These are the three types of symmetry. Symmetry means identical, look like same. Okay, now suppose it is the textbook, Understand? This page size, how much is the size on the left side page, the same size will be right hand side also. If I cut into half, if I place one another, it look like only one paper. Understand? It look like only one paper. So that is why this book is a symmetrical. Now if I draw a line from the middle, so this line is what? Symmetric line. Understand? Now if I fold like this also in the horizontal way, it look like same. If I cut like this, in this way if I cut like this, now if I fold like this, then one part only it will look like. That means this book has two lines of symmetry. How many lines of symmetry? One is horizontal way, one is vertical way. So this book has two lines of symmetry. It is a rectangle shape, that is why it has two lines of symmetry. Understand? So some figures may have more than one line of symmetry also. Suppose if you take a letter O as a circle. So if you draw like this line, two parts identical. If you draw like this also, these two parts identical. If you draw like this also, these two parts also identical. Like this, number of lines you can draw. From any way you draw a line, it will divide the circle into two equal parts, identical parts. Like that, the circle may have infinitely many lines of symmetry. Okay. Now point symmetry. Suppose if I draw a rectangle like this, I am keeping a point here. Okay. Here, if the mirror is placed here, the point will look this side. Understand? Now, again, if I rotate like this, the point will come here. The fourth time, the point will come here. That means, four times if I rotate, it will look like the same as original. Suppose the book only, if I write a letter A here, to identify, I am writing a letter A, suppose here. Now, if I rotate like this, the A gone down. If I rotate like this, the A came to another place. Again, third time, like this. Fourth time, again it came into its original position. That means, it has four. What is the order of rotation here? Four. So, when I rotated four times, it came into its original position. That is called what? Rotational symmetry. Point symmetry, line symmetry, rotational symmetry. These are the three types of symmetry. Symmetry means identical, exactly like mirror image. Okay. So, this is how we do some problems in the exercise 8.2. In that all line symmetry, rotational symmetry, point symmetry. For different objects, we have to draw the lines which divide the object into two exact identical figures. For alphabets also, from A to Z, how many letters have line symmetry, how many letters have point symmetry, how many letters have rotational symmetry, how many lines will be there for order of symmetry, that means how many lines will divide a picture into two identical figures. These are all different types of symmetry we will discuss in the coming class. With this, our symmetry topic is completed. In the exercise 8.2, we will go on to solve some questions so that we can understand. Hope you all followed today's class. In the tomorrow, that means in the coming up class, we will discuss some of the questions from 8.2. With that, we will complete our chapter. Hope you all understood today's class. Thank you.